Good luck. All right, so this isn't exactly in the teaching ladder, but I am wanting to play some more shogi this weekend and play a somewhat serious game and try out my surprise weapon for my next adversary. So let's go. All right, you might observe something different. That's cool. I'm trying to recall how all of this works. And it is a bit tricky. I think this is another way to play this. Interesting. Wasn't counting on this. Okay. How do we play here then? They're supposed to usually push this pawn, but they put the rook here. And because the rook's here, I mean, I could play wrong diagonal bishop at this point, I think. I think that's a sensible thing to do. Yeah, let's push this again. So we are in the no man's land of right fourth file rook. Let me double check that I got my overlay set up correctly. Yeah, it looks fine. Cool. Ah, so this does defend against my wrong diagonal bishop sort of idea. Okay, let's also play the king into boat castle. And depending how things go, maybe I perform the bishop exchange. Yeah, this. I'm not sure if. Yeah, I'm not miming. I know earlier we had some discussion of miming and memeing and whatever. I'm assuming you meant miming. Yeah. Check. Yeah, my mic is set. This is good. So, yeah, we have a bit of a unique strategy today, don't we? So, what's the best way to proceed here? Think this is reasonable. I was considering heavily trying to play right fourth file rook here, but that's not what we ended up with. If my king takes, they can check and I just don't panic. It's fine. We might see more than one transition this game. I didn't foresee myself playing this way. All right. So where does that leave me right now? I'm in between several different openings. Let's not drop the rook. Okay. No, there's not a need to do that here. I think my most flexible move is just build the boat. Right. This is super awkward. So, my inexperience is showing here. Wait, am I transposing into something here? Okay, that's just silly. But kind of deserved. Okay, let's push the edge. Give them something to think about here. The edge is the most obvious target, so we'll just continue pushing here. Fair enough. So right fourth vowel rook is out at this point. The new thing that's new and exciting would be sacking one of these pawns and somehow activating my pieces. They could drop the bishop here, but then the bishop becomes a massive target, and I know that it can't drop on the other diagonal if it drops them here. So, I'm not too concerned about the possibility of losing a pawn. All right, they finally shored that up. Yeah, so this is, we're not calling it a teaching ladder game, but it's an experience. Let's see what we're saying in the chat room here. Yeah, Shogi has this weird magic to just make you doze off. Well, then it's working. Especially when you play Onaguma, but all right. Let's put some pressure on this edge. I feel like I'm missing something. Well, okay. It would be nice to have a pawn in hand. Getting a pawn in hand seems super unrealistic here. Because I passed up earlier opportunities to play wrong diagonal bishop. Well, see, the thing there, even though if there's no toad castle right now, there is somebody who has like that at the beginning of their name. So. You know, if I accidentally invent a castle, then we know what to name it, I guess. Debating which pawn to push. Yeah. It's reasonable to think. There's no problem with thinking. Especially because I'm going to have to think about some things here too. I've got much to consider. Well, given where everything is located, that's actually a decent play. Given the totality of everything, this is a good square for a bishop. There's never going to be a better square for this bishop. We might as well use it. Ah. Their word for toad has the word a frog embedded in it. Welcome. You can see better than I can, but I think I signed up for a practice game here. But I'm still, I don't know, in fairness to Jen, I'm not going to be soliciting advice or stuff like that. Wait, if I play that, this pawn is loose. But that's okay. No, it's not. We'll play our silver forward. Yes, I dropped this bishop, and I've not seen anybody play this way. I have seen a bishop dropped here sometimes, not seen it dropped there. But yeah, ideally, I want a big, strong castle. And I don't want their rook to snipe at the head of my castle. And I'm kind of SOL on one of those things here. Oh, really? Really? We're having this conversation. Okay. Why this pawn move? What does it do? Does it do something? Are they very interested in this bishop drop? Is that what's going on here? I don't know. Oh, I don't have a way to allow them this bishop drop without me messing up my position, so never mind on that. Sudden Urashino. All right, here we go. Everything fits. Why this? So this silver becomes a target. Have I missed something? I spent last turn and this turn trying to find if I'm missing something, and I'm just not seeing whatever it is I missed. But yeah, I'm threatening this pawn. If the silver moves, I can drop a pawn in the rook's head. After the rook moves, I can bring back this pawn and bring the silver, or move the, advance the pawn and then bring my silver back to hit this. Afterward, my knight can join the attack. So I have an initiative here. Not sure what they see. That's a good question. I forget. Let me check. Looking at this, frogs have longer legs, which are longer than their head and body, which are meant for hopping. Toads have shorter legs and prefer to crawl around rather than hop. Frogs have smooth, somewhat slimy skin. Toads have dry, warty skin. So apparently that's the difference. Yeah. Roads, toads, whatever. Yeah. Yeah. My original thought had much more to do with their habitat, like you're saying that toads are found more inland, and frogs are almost always near water. So that's how I tended to think about it, but I just used Google to check, and it seems to confirm my suspicion. Okay. So this allows them, I guess, to drop a bishop to attack my rook. I don't see a problem with that because their silver is still loose. So I am threatening to win a silver. They might be threatening to try to get my knight by forking my rook and knight, but I could just move the rook back and the bishop doesn't make it out. This is a pin. So this attempts to win my silver if I win their silver. But more generally, they just want to exchange pieces. Well, if I move the silver back, they can push this pawn and things get ugly. There's some fun I can do if I just drop a pawn in front of their rook. Do I just drop a pawn in front of their rook? The rook takes, silver takes, they take my rook, I take their rook. That could be fun. I know they have a promoted bishop, but they bring the silver forward, my promoted or my bishop doesn't advance. Can I do better? If we exchange rooks, they can drop a rook forking these pieces. This bishop's not high enough up the board to promote. Tricky. Yeah, I guess I have the worst side of this. This is not looking good. Although if they do this fork, I can drop a rook. Their bishop can't hit this. Yeah, it's okay. And then I can take this gold. My attack is slower than their attack is, but their bishop would be caught mid-board if it's taking my silver. If I drop here directly, if they take here directly, I take, I'm fine. If I drop, if rook takes, I can attack the rook. They take my rook, I take their rook. It's not so good. Well, is it? The silver has to escape, or they lose a silver. But my bishop's not in a great place. But their silver is in a terrible place. Once the silver escapes, I don't have any follow-up tactic there. I think this is the best I can get. Oh, in Japan, both are called kairu. Now, I thought I also heard that like karo means frog or toad or something like that. Apparently, I am mistaken. So, yeah, either they're going to drop a rook and acknowledge the loss of a silver, or they're going to take a silver first. And I don't know where we go next. But I have a threat to drop a rook here and take this knight. Also, the rook would allow me to fork the gold and bishop. It's a pity. At one point, I had my translator bot in here that would try to help resolve that, but I don't know if it was the best. It was the same one that they use on the Game Grammar channel. Anyway. Yeah, so my rook drop tries to fork this knight, and if I could take that, say that, like, they brought up the goal to defend this pawn, I take the knight, or they bring it up this way, I take this knight. I have an attack on this back rank. It's not yet fatal, but it's a good start. If instead they do something to defend and prevent me from doing that, my silver could escape. Yeah, there's this open diagonal to my king, which is uncomfortable, but the bishop would have to promote to land on it. Sadly, my bishop can't promote here. It's most sad because I tried to line up with this pawn here earlier, so I could like line up all my pieces that direction. It just didn't work out that way. All right, so yeah, I'm gonna stick with my plan here. I'm gonna take a knight, threaten to take a gold. Yes, my bishop's still loose. Yes, this position's ugly. And my silver, it's not, it seems misplaced here, doesn't it? But it's fine. Now the question is, do I promote the bishop to force a rook exchange? That's what I was trying to piece through here. If I promote the bishop here, I could get my rook behind this ugly. This would be really messy. If I promoted here, they did lance takes, I took the rook, then they drop something on my rook's head, and I'm not going anywhere. And then, yeah, this is not good. So that would be too greedy. So if I harass the bishop, it goes back and protects this gold. Oh wait, I was gonna fork these. That's right. And if the bishop moves away, I could move my bishop away, or I could just take this gold. But I don't need to do the fork then. Like, I could just take the knight directly if that's my plan. Then they drop a silver, and my rook has not many squares. Yeah, that's a mess. So this fork actually has a purpose. Forcing them to drop a silver out there could be good for me. This is a mess. I try to protect here. That doesn't work. If I try the fork, they defend the gold. And sure, my bishop escapes, but I die. Yeah, let's promote up here. That's as good as this is gonna get. And we'll try to have hit the bishop whenever it's convenient, but now it just isn't. I mean, an alternative would be put a pawn behind my bishop. And that way I don't die at some future point. Well, then the rook takes, and I guess I do have a fork. Oh, if they bring the bishop in between here, That actually gets complicated because I can pin the bishop using the same pin they've got on me right now. I guess I am accidentally. I forgot this pin is still there and I have no way to break it. But I was so excited about the prospect of attacking this castle that how wrong can I be? We'll find out. Probably quite wrong because this diagonal is wide open. Oh, never mind. Everything's fine. Okay. That's weird. I did not see that coming. Okay. There is a purpose to this move. Somehow there is a purpose to this move. Okay, the purpose is to try to clear this rank. So much to read.
これより秒読みに入ります。
Oh. Yeah, so actually, wow. This is going to be a very strange move here, but I think it makes sense. Question is, which strange move? Oh,
30
wait,
秒。
my idea of the pawn drop is still here. Why don't I just do that?
40秒。
Yeah, no, this looks like a good move to me. Yes, the knight is gone. Yes, I spent a turn putting a pawn on a square. But my king becomes safer for this. They're trying to find some trick where, where somehow they can drop something into my castle. And where such a drop into my castle would be a strong move. It's just not. There is no strong drop into the center of my castle. I don't foresee there being one soon either.
30秒。40秒。 50秒。1、2、3、4、5、6。
That's a cowardly move. I keep doing cowardly moves. Oh, but yeah, now my rook bishop fork with the silver is not there anymore. I forgot about that. So, yeah, this is stupid. I should not have done that. Knight drop, as I was thinking silently, I never mentioned it, would have been suitable, but I really wanted the knight to strike at their castle. I still might use the knight to attack their castle. Really didn't want to give. The other idea I had was bring the bishop back. Which is, it's okay. I wasn't crazy about the idea. That's curious. All right, so if I don't take, I'm in about the same trouble as if I do take.
30秒。
But not quite. It's different.
40秒。
This sucks.
50秒。1、2、3、4、5、6、7、8。
I'm kind of blind here. I don't know what to do. So one idea I had was anchor my gold with the pawn. Oh, that doesn't. Well, no, my silver's defended already. I don't need to twice defend it.
30秒。
Interesting.
40秒。50秒。1、2、3、4、5、6、7。
That's a tough decision. That might be a very bad decision. Could be a very good one. Depends how good my reading is.
これより秒読みに入ります。
So, one, two, mate. That's the threat. Other threat is to take the token. Okay. I forgot they get a gold out of that. That's not good. That's not good at all. This could still be salvageable, though.
30秒。
So my bishop still covers this head. They could drop a silver here. If they do drop a silver here, if I attack forcefully enough, maybe I break in. My bishop covers this, but not really, because they'd be able to continue an attack there unless I'm super vigilant.
30秒.
This bishop here might need to stay here. My king also might run out through the first file.
40秒.
That'd be pretty interesting. But yeah, dropping another gold with check and giving Onagumo
50秒.
another gold would just, that'd be dumb.
1, 2, 3, 4,
Giving one gold was
5,
stupid enough.
6,
Two golds would be too
7, 8, 9.
much. Yeah, so if I take that, what do they do? Silver drop. If I don't take that, they drop a piece up here.
30秒.
Silver drop, gold drop. I have another gold here. What am I doing?
40秒.
It's fine. We'll just checkmate him. Nothing to worry about if we checkmate first. So I predict a gold drop here. And I'm debating, do I protect my horse? Do I drop another gold right next to it?
40秒.
Is there some third option?
50秒. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
That's not mate. That might look like mate. That can't be mate. The way I know that is my king can go left and then up here, and you have no way to chase it. As long as I'm not as generous as I've been the past few moves. You'd need at least a knight or maybe some other ranged piece to somehow ensnare my king.
40秒.
You have five generals, but that's not enough. I wonder if there is some number of generals that would actually
50秒.
checkmate me here.
1, 2.
If I could give him like 30 generals, would 30 be enough? I'm curious. There's no need for me to know that, but I just want to understand this game a little bit better. So I should have been plotting if he actually tries to defend his king, what should I do?
30秒.
That's what I should have been considering instead of moving instantly. I need to take this game more
40秒.
seriously than I'm taking it.
Gojubio. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay, now I said it wasn't mate. Never said it wasn't Hishi. But, like, really? Would I have missed something like this? I mean, I miss stuff all the time. Oh, they're threatening to drop a general on my head. I almost missed that. That's not good.
30秒.
Interesting. Well, we'll see if I die here. Yeah, I thought I had enough time. Maybe I don't have enough time. Interesting. Yeah, that's powerful. I still have some pieces in hand. I wonder, maybe this whole time I've missed something terrifically obvious. Maybe I could actually take the silver and mate somehow? That seems really unlikely, but it'd be interesting if that were the case. That can't be. Okay. Interesting. If I take silver drop, if I take silver takes, if I move, check again. Is that mate?
30秒.
Wait, now if I retreat here, I don't vacate the square.
40秒. Sanju 40秒.
Now we enter the phase of the game where I flip a coin. Just how many times to see if I can mate? That makes one of us. One of us found a mate. I'm still looking. Pretty sure I don't have it. What I do have might not be mate, but it's just enough, I don't know, being super tense here that I just can't sit here anymore. I have to make a move.
30秒.
Well,
40秒.
could maybe be a mate here. Yeah, that's interesting. Oh, bishop. It's a bit generous. Yeah, I'm not seeing it. I'm very much not seeing the mate here. Rook trap. Check. No, they block. Every when and where,
30秒.
everyone, they block.
30秒40秒50秒1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8
None of this works. Yeah, I'm just spacing out. I don't see anything. I'm trying many different things, but none of them are close. I guess I did get a bishop. Well, this is tense. Check. King up. Checkmate. Yeah. Check, king back, check. That's like a gold moving across the rank. That is tense. Gold trap. Yeah, that's me. Thanks for your game. Jeepers! All right. Instead of rook 3-2, there's a much, much better move. My rook in the hand was needed for mate. If he had silver 8-8 instead of silver 8-9, he would have mated me. Alright, so let's see where we go. I know we were all very excited about this. Yeah. He missed this line. Yeah, there's just a so many lines here. So many lines. This would have been mate two. I thought so, I wasn't sure. I had ideas. So what was I? Yeah, that's what I was thinking. And then knight takes. Yeah. This is what I had been considering. And it doesn't quite cut it. His sleep deprivation doesn't help his reading ability. That's probably true. Yeah, I guess. Yeah, there's a lot going on this game. There's a set of rules on the site that recommends that if you're trying to learn to play better, start your analyses from the beginning of the game. So here I was practicing right fourth file rook, and that never happened here. So we got to play static rook instead, which I haven't touched in a while. This bishop drop is kind of weird. I thought it was good. In retrospect, it's probably not. And yeah, this is why not. Yeah, the silver, I don't know. I was so optimistic until I actually saw these positions and then had to read through them, but yeah, I didn't see. There are a lot of variations here. Engines and spectators alike will likely point out a lot of things that both of us missed. So yeah, this rook drop is I think it's a good move because my bishop ends up pinned here, even after they have material parity. I could have tried to block this bishop from promoting, but I didn't think it worked out well. Yeah, and then this. Oh, yeah, I played some silly moves after this pawn drop happened. Pawn drop 2-5, I think, is fine. But moves that followed were not so fine. Let's hear what his comment is. Well. Yeah, Onaguma really likes gold generals. But also I did not defend this correctly at all. Earlier I probably could have put the knight somewhere in here or even brought back the bishop. Yeah. So Yeah, he exploited my errors. I could probably defend, I don't know, like this or something. I don't know if he can see that or not. Let me go back. Oh, he can. Okay. And then I can just take here. And this way, they don't have a token right next to my king. This would have been fine. This would have been, like, yeah, night and day, so much easier to defend than what I ended up in. Let's not say there's no challenges, but this would have been a lot easier to hold on to. Oh, you would have taken the gold also? Well, that's good to know. So, yeah, this spending a move to defend my bishop apparently is careless. That really underestimated the severity of his threat. And I thought there were many problems after I gave the bishop, but this is even. I mean, here I'm surviving, but yeah, taking the gold, giving the bishop would have been better. He calls this the rotate. Well, yeah, that's if. Well, I guess I kind of have to recapture that one. Interesting. Yeah, no, you have a good point. Oh. Yeah, that deals with the tactic, the fork, of course. There can't be a fork if there's. Yeah, sticking the knight in the middle allows all these forks, but this is just cleaner. Yeah, sure, I'm still pinned, but, yeah. And there are practical problems there, but it can be dealt with. What I did really opened wide the door for a lot of pain. Even this could be played. I don't know why I suggested this knight drop when, like, this one seems easier. Wait, can I not just. What? Okay, I'll take that. I don't even have to take the token. I mean, yeah, he's got an initiative. But. How do I best attack this castle? I wouldn't be so ch confident there if I were in their shoes, but yeah. I mean, I might offer this 2-for-1 thing, you know? It's. I've got an initiative. Yeah, that could be. Oh wait, well, hang on. So Hanaguma really enjoys gold generals, and I've given them just now a gold general. Yeah, so this is not so good either. Interesting. Yeah, this is about even at best for me. And at worst, it's not even that good. How do I deal with this? Oh, just don't give him a gold. Duh. If I don't want to see them have a gold general on their castle, don't give them a gold general. We'll think about it. we'll consider Is there any particular reason you ask? So this way he doesn't get a gold because I don't give him the gold general immediately. Unlike all these other lines where I'm just giving him that, here he's got a knight, but yeah, I saw like somebody raided her and I didn't even bother watching it. But yeah, apparently that's her latest gig. Still doesn't quite answer my question, though. Is there something particular you're wanting to see here? Oh wait, why did I do that? That's a bit silly, isn't it? I want to checkmate. So I should try to checkmate, right? Wait, no, the point of this is that I don't want to give up this gold. Yeah. So yeah, here. Let's see. Oh, my stream title. Yeah, technically this was not the Shogi teaching ladder. Although the ladder is in week 90. This game was an unofficial, unsanctioned teaching game. It's kind of like in that one episode of what's it, the IT Crowd, where they end up playing Countdown on the streets. And because it's physically located on the street, it's like the same game, but they just play it on the street. Yeah, so yeah, it dawned on me after moving the gold that way. This is really where it belongs. Favorite amphibian? I don't know. See. So now I can finally get this in. Oh, well, technically they could block. They don't. This is the same exercise all over again, except this time my attack is like instantaneous. Yeah, so I definitely should have done something much more like this. I'm just gonna take that. And then take here. And then I've got five generals to drop. So, yeah, this looks reasonably straightforward. Yeah. Yeah, So, yeah, this is what I meant when I said I just defended very much incorrectly. And now I have a better understanding still, thanks to this post-game analysis. Like, bring the gold toward the king here. Don't exchange the gold if I don't want him to have a gold. And now I've got 3 golds and 2 silvers in hand, and yeah, that's much easier. And why gold is so important is because my king might have to run up the board. I wonder what the actual weakness of Onaguma is. It's a question that got raised on the Road to Shodan series on Shogi Harbor's YouTube channel. I am curious what its weakness is. So, yeah, normally this edge is the weakness, but so you still got that covered, but yeah, with the gold out of the way, everything's a weakness now. Admittedly, I don't have knights to like checkmate it in the corner. Yeah. So that's pretty cool. Yes, that's better said. That and I suffered this in the game I shared yesterday on Shogi Harbor's channel. I played Onaguma, and then I'm like, well, it's my turn to attack now, right? No. That's not how it works. So, yeah. I don't automatically get to attack just when I want to. Oops. Sorry, I should give this back. If they don't have it already. Yeah, so. Yeah, this happened. I tried to save my gold because I don't want to give them another gold. 2 golds would be too much, I think. Is there something up with this, I wonder, though? Like, this lands with check. I was very much not on board allowing this, but maybe it's playable? Oh, that would be nice. If I could do that, that'd be nice. But, like, what now? Okay. So I'm maintaining that here, this is not something I wanted to deal with, but maybe it's okay. I didn't think it was. I thought I was host here. Okay. Oh, I'm sorry. I missed a tactic here. Yeah. Yeah, no, he's right that in that position he's faster. I think. I could be wrong, but either way, this tactic would have won the knight and helped tremendously. Here, I still have an attack. I playing as Gota here. Huh? What's going on there? This is curious. Maybe I need to push there instead, but I wonder. Yeah, this is tricky. It's mate here. Oh, that'll settle it. Yeah, that's a nice one. I was on the right path. I was looking everywhere else I could use the bishop, but yeah, that actually mates. Good point. So, yeah, I guess I forget exactly what the variation was, but yeah. There's some lines where I can't just haul off and start attacking right away. I wonder how many times I tried to measure the bishop landing here and not hitting this gold there. Yeah. So that's why, yeah, I ran with my gold. Jian did this sack, and then did this, and then that, and then let's see. I'm trying to find scroll up and see what the comment was, which I think was like if he'd taken an 8-9 instead of playing at 8-8. I think that was the comment. That Kyo had made. I'm trying to find. If Jin had silver takes 8-8 promotion instead of promoted silver takes 8-9, he could have checkmated me. Okay, so guess we haven't hit that yet. Should have let this not promoted, he says. Well, hang on. I mean, that's a possibility. Before we go too deep down this line, I wonder, do I have this? Because like that's his primary threat here is to drop right in front of my king. Because I've had this interesting formation where I've pushed my pawn twice and it's created a weakness. This looks like the most challenging defense, I think. And I'm not sure how the attack continues. Interesting. Still not sure. It's got me interested. I don't have a choice here but to retreat. Okay. And then what? Oh, I'm sorry. That's walking into mate in one. Oops. Yes, I'd have to go back this way. This threatens mate once more. Well, yeah, now there's nothing to block with on this back row. But I guess I don't have any ranged pieces set up yet either, because I just gave away my rook. Either way, this is complicated. Let's see. Another fun bit is my bishop can maybe retreat here, and maybe it's okay. Wait, so this silver takes 8-8. It's interesting. If I go here, here, no, that's no good. Yeah, this might save my butt. That's pretty funny. Yeah, so we still haven't gotten to the line you'd suggested, but here you're also suggesting had this silver promoted, it would be mate in this particular position. Sorry, we're bouncing around a lot of lines here. It's complicated. So I'm not sure exactly. We still haven't hit the line where silver takes 8-8 promotion instead of scrolling up again to see it. Instead of promoted silver takes 8-9. We still haven't hit that point yet, but yeah, in principle, you're probably right. Yeah, so it's definitely an annoying bishop. Wow. Okay, yeah, that's curious. Yeah. So that's a good point. And then here, if I take this way, that's oh, that is a mating net. Yeah, so that forces mate. Which is to say that this refutes that idea. So all that means I have to take here. But this can't possibly work this time, because I've given away my rook. There's no way, right? Yeah. What about, oh, promoted bishop takes 8-2. So I wonder this? Do I have a next move here? Silver 7-1. Oh. That's a way to, yeah, get my rook back into the game. Interesting. That could maybe work. That looks convincing. I'm not saying what I played in the game works either, but this could work. Yeah, I'm not sure what to try next here. I have two gold drops right next to the king. Neither of them looks better than the other. Well, maybe this one. Maybe this one. I have to keep my rook close. Like, if I promote the bishop, the rook's shut out. I can't use the bishop there much as I really want to. But I can try to get my dragon close and hope that there's something. Oh, why did I. Yeah. It's complicated. Hang on. Maybe I'm supposed to drop this here. Maybe that's what this pawn is for. But it means I can't use the pawn later. Oh, I have another pawn now. How did that happen? Yeah, you have to block against this, right? Oh. No, that doesn't look right. Can I just transpose? Okay, yeah, that one works too, sure. So, at the very least, this is complicated, but oh, duh. Hello. That's beautiful. Yeah. So the remaining idea, yeah, the remaining idea would be to try to interpose something here. But I don't know how this could work. Yeah. So I'm a bit confused. Admittedly, that is more compelling than I thought it would be, but still, I'm not sure that that suffices. It looks like go to escapes just barely. Unless there's some way I could involve both kings next to each other, but that seems unlikely. Yeah, that's a fair point. You have to try to play with the cards you have here, so. I mean, sure. Yeah, walk into the line of the dragon, why not? How bad could that be, right? Oh, why would you tempt fate like this? Is there some reason to, like, not just take the easy win? Okay. See, I think the rook takes a2. I'm sorry, the bishop takes a2 is a very good try, but not quite. It's almost there, but not quite. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, what about Bishop 5-1 instead of Rook 5-1? Actually, that's interesting. So, am I missing something here? Wait, so I play this here. And we're saying bishop 5-1 in this case. Are you sure? Oh, the rook can still approach, can't it? Even with the bishop there, because this is not a chess rook. This dragon can move like that. That's kind of interesting. That's pretty cool. I don't think it mates. Oh, then bishop 5-2. Sorry. I messed up then. Bishop 5-2? I still don't see where this is going. Oh, hang on. Well, that's cool. Okay. I'm trying to find what next. Oh, then I can drop a gold here. Well, that's not quite good enough. Unless somehow this cuts it. That's tricky. Yeah, so I guess this mates. So somehow during the game I missed this. You'll have to forgive me for missing it. So that's amazing. But yeah, in the game, guess we're gonna get there soon enough. Right, so we've gone back to the main line. All right, so I'm the host. Silver 7-8 happened. And I'm trying to catch what it was. I kept repeating this out loud, but I don't have the memory. Instead of promoted silver takes 8-9. Promoted silver takes 8-9 happened on 72. And this, you're saying, would have made it. Oh, so how does this checkmate? How does this work? Like, I really want to take the horse, but seems difficult to checkmate after doing that, unless the same bishop drop tactic. Yeah, maybe there's another drop on 7-9 here, whether it's a bishop or something else. Maybe. Maybe not. This is not easy. I mean, if they take this pawn. Doesn't. I wonder. Take the pawn, king takes, silver drop, king back, bishop drop, king over. If we already dropped the silver, we don't have another silver to drop. Oh. Wait, is this knight drop, pawn takes, 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 check, back? Yeah, okay, this is probably it. We take here, and then we take drop here. And then how is there not a mate? Oh no! No, this is not good enough. Oh, wait, that's bizarre. Well, damn. This is strange. So then this runs, and then, yeah, that doesn't mate. And other attempts. Okay, sorry. So the knight drop is maybe not right. Oh, you didn't think it was a horse. I still think. I wonder, though. That's tricky. So, like, there's no easy forced mate here. Maybe there's still a he, she, or there may be still a mate here. But, okay. I'm gonna trust Jien on this because he does a lot of sume. Yeah. So. Yeah, that's unfortunate. That was close. That was super close. Yeah, that makes sense. There's a lot going on here. Oh, sorry, let me give that back. I still wonder, because like this promoted silver takes 8-9 didn't convince me, but my attack might not have succeeded with best play. Okay, yes, if I take there, yeah, this mates directly. So that does. Wait. What's this? Eh. Oh, my horse is still there. How did my horse. It's the horse that never goes away. But yeah, somehow. Something didn't feel right here. Oh, I see. Now he's saying because. Yeah, I thought that there was a mate. What about gold takes 8-7? I don't know. Yeah, that's what I was trying to read out when Jien suggested a different move. Yeah, gold takes 8-7 could be of interest. It had my interest, and that's why I was like lingering on this position. I thought maybe it works. So, yeah, what about this is what we're asking. I'm not sure this quite cuts it, but okay, never mind. So here, there's only one move. Silver drop looks most obvious. Yeah, I can't see other moves working there. The knight drop looks kind of interesting, but yeah, it doesn't seem to help any, but that's unfortunate. Yeah. Yeah, it still seems like it's unfair that I win in this position, but I'm not seeing an alternative. Pardon me, I'll be back in 1 minute here. I have returned. Yeah, so there's a lot of variations there. Well, the knight drop, the problem is I just do the horse takes knight, but yeah. It's to me it felt yeah. Yeah, I guess he played it as best as could be played, and that's kind of incredible. That's at least my guess. Yeah. Who could have predicted this, right? Onaguma falls once more. And there was much rejoicing. Yeah, couldn't find anything else there. Cool. Let me put this on the big board. Try to give some more thoughts on the matter here. I know, Jien initially asked if anybody in the Shogi Harbor Discord server wanted to play a game, and I offered, well, if nobody else takes you up on it, I will, because there's something I want to try out. And something indeed did get tried out this game. That was a cool move. Would have been really, really, I was going to say smart or clever or something if this actually took the point home. Yeah, the thing I was most concerned about was this kind of thing. We just reinforce the castle. Sure, it costs some time. Sure, I'm just gonna take that, but I thought maybe there's some chance that this castle's just strong enough, and then you return back and checkmate me. But yeah, that's not how things played out in the game. Instead, we both went for mate. We both attempted to checkmate each other immediately. I took this one tempo out trying to defend, and note this move. Either is brilliant or terrible. There's no in between. Yeah. I don't know. They've played before, right? The thing that was a bit terrifying here was the prospect of after last weekend I lost to a 2Q, losing to a 4Q. Wouldn't that be exciting? Although, I mean, it's all numbers, all ranks. What does it all mean? Instead of promoted rook takes 7-8. Yeah, this. My immediate reaction on rook takes gold was that's not mate. Yeah, silver at 6-8, we say. To protect this token. 6-8. I was thinking 6-9 or 6-7. If this works, that's really clever. Because I would never guess this. Oh, 6-7. Okay, yeah. Okay, that. Yeah, this is what I was considering during the game. It's actually harder to deal with than I thought. Yeah, this looks painful. So. Oh boy. Yeah, I don't have an answer to that. That's a good move. That's a very good move. See. All right, what the heck? Let's find out just how mated I am here. This has got to be mate, right? They drop here and go up there. And they do this, and this is mate. Yeah, it's not even close. So I can't just play an idle move there. And if I drop gold generals, this position becomes impossible. And if I try something clever like this, it's just no better. Because, yeah, I just have nothing here. Yeah, I'm pretty sure your suggestion, silver 6-7, that just wins. Unless I can sack for mate. And again, I have my doubts, but, like, surely, there's no way this could work, right? I do have a silver in hand now that I've taken the silver. But, there's got to be some many differences. Well, wait a second. So wait, they have to take the silver. Then I can recapture here, and then we see similar lines. Gold here, king up, horse there, king up. And then if it goes like this, then what? Oh, then this still mates over here. So that's not available. The king can't go there because of the horse. Can't go here because of that checkmate. We'd have to go here. Yeah, so this might still work. Right, because there's yeah, gold mates. Right? Gold here. Gold there. Oh, I don't have the rook on this file anymore. Interesting. Check, maybe. Wait, why did I drop the gold? Yeah, here. Duh. So instead it would need to be a try like that, but that also walks into the same thing. So yeah, silver drop 7-1 seems to be our star move today. I've never seen this pattern before with like this gold and then the dragon and then the horse. That weaving of all the pieces together, I've not seen that. So thanks very much. Let me attempt to pronounce this. Kyogen Mawashi. Thank you for guiding me through all these variations here. It's been an interesting exercise. And now I understand that, yeah, taking this actually sometimes does result in mate if you've got a lot of pieces. I thought I would always have to be taking the knight. Usually it's the edge attack, like on this edge, that would prevail. But since all the gold is removed from the castle, there actually become some other tactics. At a high cost, but the king is worth that cost. Yeah. Hope we all enjoyed this game. Yeah. Condolences to Jen for this is just a really difficult thing to defend, and this is just how things turned out in time pressure. Yeah, during the game, yeah, we looked at, well, afterward, we looked at other variations, so. This seemed to be good enough. There might be some hole somewhere, but Who knows? Yeah, thanks to all for joining and watching. Hope we enjoyed this.